Welcome to the class, and in this I'm going to talk about what is full employment equilibrium. We're going to talk about that. We're also going to do a little bit of theory in this. In the next class, we're going to talk about with the help of diagrams. So in this, I'm just going to explain the concept of full employment. So what is full employment? An economy is said to be in full employment when all the resources of the economy are utilized. How much is demanded? That much is supplied. So aggregate demand is equal to aggregate supply. That is effective demand, but of the full resources of the economy. It's absolutely full swing and equilibrium. So that is full employment equilibrium. And in this we are going to talk about two situations where aggregate demand is equal to at the full employment equilibrium. What happens is sometimes AD is less than AS and sometimes AD is more than AS. Sometimes aggregate demand is less than aggregate supply, and at the full employment sometimes it is more. So this will make it very clear what is it all about, and this is actually the crux of the entire all that we've studied, all of it. Like for example, when we talked about the concepts, whatever we are doing, we were trying to get at this moment to discuss full employment, and with that we're going to talk about inflationary pressures and deflationary pressures in order to find out where we stand or how do we tackle such problems. So the government should know, it should be in the know of things, and that is why, you know, the Central Statistical Organization or something of that sort, the one who collects data, it becomes of prime importance. It's so important for the government to know about the statistics which are there for them to study and make policies accordingly. So we are going to talk about what is full employment of resources, and so just a little theoretical exposition of this particular theory that we will do, and then we will do in the previous class we analyzed the determination equilibrium level of income within the Keynesian framework. Now, according to Keynes, the equilibrium level of income need not necessarily be at the full employment level, though full employment equilibrium is an ideal situation which every economy tries to achieve but may be unable to do so. Now, if the aggregate demand is less than full employment aggregate supply, the economy will only achieve underemployment equilibrium. And this situation is known as deficient demand. So, talking about deficient demand, AD is less than AS at full employment equilibrium. Now, let's take the other hand. On the other hand, what happens? I hope you can see my... So, on the other hand, what happens? If AD, aggregate demand, is more than aggregate supply at full employment level, this is called excess demand. So again, I've made these two boxes for you to understand that these are the two situations. One is which is known as deficient demand, and one is excess demand. So when AD is less than AS at full employment equilibrium, that is known as deficient demand. When AD is greater than AS, when aggregate demand is greater than AS at full employment level, then it is known as excess demand. So then we will be talking about the causes of excess deficient demand and what are the remedies to it and how do we go about it. And so also we're going to talk about excess demand, how does it come about and how do you tackle that and all of it. So we'll be doing that in the next few classes.